waiting. They were waiting.
Professor? There's something here.
Be careful, Chisholm. Whatever that is, it's been buried in this ice for millennia.
I can't go back there! No! No!
Oh my God!
No!
He could never get his fingers around G sharp.
You're actually telling me you taught Elvis to play guitar?
Well, not very well, obviously. How long's that been flashing?
Search me, what is it?
Someone's sending an SOS.
To the TARDIS?
I doubt it, to anyone that's passing. Generally, people aren't choosy who answers when they send a distress signal. Here we go.
Where are we?
The Arctic Circle somewhere. And the TARDIS will keep you warm, at least for a while. Now, that signal wasn't too strong. Couldn't lock on all that accurately.
It's an earthquake. I mean, an ice quake.
Just a little glacial movement.
Yeah, just a little glacial movement for you and your hobnail boots. We're wearing heels here.
From the look of these, I'd say we're on some sort of floating ice plateau.
Where are you going?
Just a quick look around.
Didn't you listen to anything I just said?
No.
Amy, you stay here. I'll see if I can reach the skidoo rider down there.
Please don't fall to your death. I don't fancy living in an igloo. Not without central heating.
Oh, Amy, I didn't know you cared.
Amy, can you tie this rope to something, please?
We need to find a way to winch this fellow up.
Sure! I'll tie the rope to the skidoo's winch, Doctor. Let me know when to start the motor.
Here you go. Get some warmth into you.
Where am I?
You fell. Looks like your ankle is sprained. But I'll soon get you out of here, don't worry. Don't worry. We'll soon have you sorted out.
All right, Amy, start the motor.
That's the way. Brilliant.
Doctor!
Amy! Are you all right?
I'm okay, but you look kind of stuck.
Don't think so. The skidoo did the trick after all.
There's another way out of here!
You'd better get a move on. These shoes really aren't much good on ice, especially when it's shaking.
Come on. Don't mean to worry you, but the whole plateau could be about to collapse.
I'm sorry, but I won't be able to climb anything.
Don't worry. I'll make a route that's easier for you.
Soon get you back to your base. Where is it?
Not there. No, no! I can't go back there! No!
Why? What's wrong?
Waiting. They were waiting.
He's delirious.
No, Amy. He's terrified.
Well, he's not going to tell us where he came from now.
So we're gonna have to find it ourselves.
Exactly. Whatever has happened there, someone sent an SOS. So there are people there who need our help.
Good thing I salvaged the sat-nav from the skidoo. That should help point us in the right direction.
It looks a bit smashed up to me.
I repaired the great Klaxian generators of Thrad. I got the ionic flux engines of the Dragadorf Imperial flagship running with an old chewing gum wrapper and a mousetrap.
I think I can fix a sat-nav. If I hook this up to the TARDIS,
I can rewire it in no time.
Bingo! Now we have the coordinates.
Right. Now we find out what got our friend Chisholm so terrified.
Yeah, like that's a good idea.
Of course it is. Why wouldn't it be?
Doctor, did you ever see the thing?
The Carpenter Kurt Russell thing or the Howard Hawks thingy with the walking carrot?
Not sure I see your point, anyway.
You brought me back! Well, they'll get us all!
I give you my word, I'll protect you. Whatever happened here, I can help, I promise.
How? They got everybody! They changed them!
Into what?
Like robots. Slaves. Cyber slaves.
Cyber slaves?
Amy, get out of the way!
What was that?
A cyber mat.
It's not anything like a mouse mat. It didn't look like one.
Weird. I've seen them kill people before, but never turn people into robots. That's new. That's fascinating. Why would they do that? Let me take a look.
No! Get away! Get away from me! And get out of here.
You have to let me help you.
It's too late for me now.
What's going on here?
I think the answer to that is in there.
Yeah, of course. It would be.
Knock, knock. Oh, hello. And who are you then? Conversation not your strong point, is it? Amy, I'll keep his attention while you think of a way to overpower
him. I thought that was your job.
I thought you liked to be independent. Now, if you could think of something, fast.
We must eliminate.
Well done, Amy. Let's see if we can learn a bit more about this fellow. This keycard says it belongs to Alan Watts. I imagine that's who he used to be.
Used to be?
The Cybermat nanoforms have done their work. Nothing really left of Alan here. Poor chap.
Watch out, Amy. There's another cyber slave around the corner.
Oh, this place gives me the creeps.
Until we know exactly what's going on, we need to watch our step. Look, a tin can on legs. Meet my can opener.
It did not like that.
The sonic signal gives them a cyber migraine. The sonic's frequency keeps them at bay. We might be able to rig something at another frequency to stun or deactivate them.
That would be good. Those things are worse than spiders.
Spiders? I'd rather we change the subject. Let's see if we can get some information out of this system. We better be cautious here.
Doctor, look out!
You don't get many visitors up here, do you?
I thought you were one of them. Who are you?
This is Amy and I'm the Doctor. We answered your distress beacon.
Thank God! My name's Elizabeth Meadows. I've been barricaded in here for days.
It's all right. The doctor will be able to help.
What happened to your arm?
I fell and hurt it running away from those things. They're everywhere.
You mean the cybermats?
They bite. Inject a nanovirus that converts flesh and bone into living machinery.
Cyber slaves? Slaves to who?
To the Cybermen, of course. Where did you find this?
We're a geological survey. It must have been under the ice for 10,000 years.
Amazing.
So who are the Cybermen?
Cybernetic bodies with living brains. Brains surgically removed from those they conquer. Stripped of everything but the urge to kill and convert more like themselves.
And they've been under the ice 10,000 years.
Apparently. And the Cybermats have been converting a small army of slaves to dig them out. Is that right, Professor?
Yes. I've been trying to develop an antidote. Something that will reverse the nanovirus. Make my team human again.
You're very good. But it won't work. We need a sample of the virus in its pure form.
You stay here, Professor, and do what you can. Amy, we're going to catch ourselves a cybermat. There's a handheld distress beacon here. That'll do nicely.
I thought you were more into answering SOS calls, not making them.
This is just what we need to deal with the cybermats.
Clarification request.
If I can get it to emit the same frequency pulse as the sonic screwdriver, but stronger, it will work like an EMP device and disable them all.
Sounds like a plan to me.
Excellent. I've set up the beacon to emit an amplified sonic burst.
So set it off and all the cybermats in the station go bang.
Afraid it's not quite that simple. To make sure we take out as many cybermats as possible, we have to drop it right into their nest.
And where is the nest?
That is what we need to find out. Can you hear that? The cybermats are in the air ducting system. It surfaces the whole base, so they'll be everywhere. Sneaky devils, aren't they?
Can we get them through here?
Too dangerous. If I open this hatch, whoosh! Do you fancy getting covered in cybermats? Best to get them from above.
So you're going through the vent system?
Am I wearing a Bruce Willis vest? Besides, I won't fit. There's another vent hatch up there. If I distract them from down here, you might be able to open it.
Me?
Sorry. I'm not really ventilation duct size. I can distract them for you with the sonic screwdriver.
It's a plan, I suppose.
Take the beacon, climb up there, and while I keep the cybermats occupied with the sonic, see if you can open the vent up there.
Okay. I think I can manage that.
And try to avoid any cybermats while you're up there.
Thanks. Doctor of the Flaming Obvious now, are you?
I mean it, they're dangerous. You know what they can do.
Doctor? I see the nest. I'm setting off the beacon.
Amy?
It's all right, I'm fine. Then again, maybe not.
Amy, are you all right?
Man, never around when you want a job doing. Changing a plug, sorting out a cyber slave.
I don't know why I was ever worried about you.
Perfect. A nanosynthesizer, just what Professor Meadows needs. She can get a sample of the cyber virus from this. Come on.
Fort Cecil to GSO Zebra Bay. Fort Cecil to GSO Zebra Bay. Do you read me? Confirming supply delivery.
What? They can't come here. We have to stop them. Fort Cecil, this is GSO Zebra Bay. Stay away. Do you hear me? Stay away.
Do you read us?
It's not working.
The capacitor's blown.
Like that means anything to me.
Look, this is it. I have to get back to Professor Meadows.
Find another capacitor, Amy, get the radio working again and warn Fort Cecil.
And now I'm a radio engineer. Great. Hello, Mr. Chisholm. Are you there?
Why are you still here?
I need to ask you a question. Do you know where I can find a capacitor for the radio? It's broken and we need to warn Fort Cecil.
There's a spare one in my locker. The code is 3245.
Thank you. This supposed to go? Ah, I see it. There. Now, let's see if we have a connection. The GSO to Fort Cecil. Hello? Roger and all that.
GSO Zebra Bay, this is Fort Cecil reading you. Are you confirming the delivery?
No, we have a situation here. We need you to hold off on that delivery. Don't come anywhere near here until we give you the green light. Is that clear?
What is happening?
Polar flu. Really, really bad outbreak. We need to be quarantined just to be safe.
Roger that. Let us know if we can help.
Thanks. GSO out.
Over and out.
They really say that? Now, where did the doctor get to?
Professor Meadows? Elizabeth? When I said stay here, I meant stay here. Why don't people do what I tell them? Well, let's see what I can do about this serum. Ah, Amy, look. One synthesized nano serum. Who's a clever boy then?
Yeah? Well, I fixed the radio and warned Fort Cecil. You're not the only brain box around here.
You managed it. Brilliant. We can't allow anyone to get near this base. Cybermats are bad enough, but those Cybermen under the ice are something else entirely. We need to find out how close the cyber slaves are to releasing the Cybermen and hope there's still time to stop them.
All right. Where's Meadows?
I don't know. When I got back, she'd gone. I don't like that at all.
We should get the serum to Chisholm.
You're right. First things first. I've developed a serum. It will reverse the nanovirus. Please, come down and take it.
Are you sure it'll work? I've seen what happened to the others. I don't want to end up like that. I'd rather be dead.
I can't be sure how long it will take to work, but believe me, you're going to be all right.
Did you find Meadows?
Yes, but now she's disappeared.
Had she been infected?
Apart from an injured arm, she seemed fine. But now I can't find her on the base. Any idea where she could have gone?
Only the excavation.
But that's where the cyber slaves are digging, isn't it? She's got to be mad.
This whole project is hers. This is her team. She would do anything to save them.
How do we get to the excavation?
There's a lift. In the lab.
Yes, I saw that. But the door had a heavy security lock.
I'll get us past that. It's a closed environment. There's a retinal scanner to log who goes down there.
Oh, I don't think you're going any further. Let the serum do its job. I can handle things from here. Going down for household appliances and homicidal Cybermen.
Yep, you are so funny.
Careful. This place is crawling with cyber slaves.
Looks like a network of tunnels. Why dig all those?
Standard procedure in digs. You dig a cross pattern of trenches, or in this case, tunnels, until you find what you're looking for.
And they found it?
They weren't looking for what they found. If only they had never started to look.
I think we're okay.
must have crashed here before the last ice age.
And it's just been waiting here for someone to dig it out.
The Cybermen will be in suspended animation, but the ship will have been sentient since it crashed, listening for signs of life on the surface. When it heard the GSO excavating, it sent out the Cybermats. Clever stuff, really. And deadly. Once the Cybermen are awake, they'll complete their mission. Cyber conversion of every human being on Earth. Amy, come stand on here. I'll start the lift.
What about you?
Well, there must be another lift up there that you can activate for me.
Why are we even trying to get up there?
I need to get to the control room of that ship. I need to find out how close they are to waking the Cybermen.
And I have to stop them.
Just one animated Cyberman. That's all it could take to start converting the whole human race.
Okay, let's do it.
Amy, press the button!
I'll take this lift next, Doctor.
Can you give me a hand?
Sure. Doctor! Help me!
Amy, leave her alone! Don't you dare hurt her! Amy!
Think. Where are they taking her? It must be to the control room up there. I don't have much time.
Professor Meadows, I was afraid the Cybermats had got you.
Ah, I see.
I don't think so, Doctor.
You must spend hours in front of the mirror in the morning.
Humor is a redundant application of intellect.
I don't know. I find it comes in quite handy in a tight spot. So you were a cyber slave from the start.
And you answered the distress call I directed at your TARDIS.
What do you want with me? And what have you done with my friend Amy? That's a cyber conversion chamber. Don't you dare touch her.
Then comply with my demand.
Which is?
This ship was caught in a temporal storm and crashed. The cryo systems are too badly damaged for us to repair, to reanimate my cyber brethren. But you, Doctor, you have the genius of a Time Lord.
You want me to wake a Cyberman invasion of Earth? You're mad.
It is your choice, Doctor. Wake them, or your companion becomes the first of a new line of Cybermen.
All right, I'll do it.
Lord, I have reactivated you.
Your protocol has been successful. Now you will be deleted.
But I gave you life.
No, you don't have to kill her.
Cybermen do not require cyber slaves. Cybermen are superior to all.
Crisis averted. Take my time.
Doctor! Doctor, get me out of here! Please!
I'm here. I'll get you free straight away.
Please get me out of here before you press... Please get me out of here before you press any buttons. Get these cuffs off me. Thanks, Doctor. But what kept you? Let's get out of here. They're almost through the door.
First, I need to get back to the control room.
Back to the control room? Why?
Because I need to stop the Cybermen.
How?
Not quite sure yet. Come on.
We need to be careful. Okay.
Isn't this dangerous? There must be Cybermen all over the place.
Yes, but this is the only place we can stop them.
Where are they going?
Fort Cecil, the only people for 100 miles. They'll convert them and move on.
Including you, Doctor. You will be deleted.
Delete this.
Feeling better, Mr. Chisholm?
I am now.
But what about Fort Cecil? How do we stop the Cybermen?
We turn their own bodies against them.
And you know exactly how to do that?
Of course. I can reprogram the nanoforms in the Cybermen's body chemistry to attack them. At least, I hope I can.
Do the trick, and we should have about half an hour to get out of here before it blows.
2 minutes to critical mass.
And there was me looking forward to a leisurely stroll.
Sorry about that. Maybe we should run. Plan? In the end?
Do you even know what a plan is?
That'll be the Fort Cecil plane.
Not a bad day's work, then. The nanovirus will have reversed with the destruction of the ship. They'll be good as new.
There's going to be a lot of questions.
Most of them asked by someone from UNIT, I dare say. Just mention my name and you'll be okay.
You never said. What is it?
The Doctor. Just... the Doctor.